The iconic Queen's Plate, Canada's most prestigious thoroughbred horse race, is happening this Saturday. And yes, the million-dollar action does happen on the track. But this morning, we're prepping your eyes for some of the stunning fashion pieces that you will be watching, you're going to be seeing when you watch the race. Many of them will be created by our next guest, the Queen's Plate official milliner, the man who has studied with the Royal Milliner, Canada's milliner, David Dunkley. He is our guest, along with his beautiful works of art. Welcome back.
Thank you so very much. I'm delighted to be here.
Such a privilege to have you. And thank you for bringing me this amazing fascinator.
You're welcome. I call that my English fascinator.
The English
fascinator. It was the very first thing I ever learned to make with Her Majesty's hatmaker.
Incredible. First of all, for people who do not know, what does milliner mean?
A milliner is someone who designs and embellishes, the traditional definition, is somebody who designs and embellishes ladies' hats and creates them. So that is what I am.
That is exactly what you are. Okay, let's go through some of these fascinators. And for people who may not remember, because we talked a lot about this around Royal Wedding, difference between a hat and a fascinator.
That's a very good question. Mm-hmm. A hat is, by definition, has a 3-inch crown and a minimum of a 2-inch brim, and it fits on your head. So there are miniature hats, but a hat, by definition, is that.
Okay, well, this counts as a hat then, right?
That
this first
is full
one?
On beautiful. A hat. Nice, beautiful red cinema. I custom create my colors in my shop, so Canada's leading horse race. How could you not have a red hat for that?
Gorgeous. And then this one next to it. I love this circular shape with a veil.
Thank you very much. I call this my floating veil. So again, using the same technique as I made for you, my English fascinator, I create this floating veil. What I love about this is if you are at the Queen's Plate, when you're standing outside, it can sometimes be a little hot.
Yes.
And you might be getting your picture taken a lot. So in the hats and horseshoes section. So this particular one will let the light through. It'll breathe. You'll be quite comfortable with this.
I love your pieces, David. You instantly feel more elegant. Like, it just elevates everything. I love it.
Thank you. But we like to say that the hats are the fascinators compliment and punctuate your outfit.
Oh, I like that a lot. What about for men? More and more men getting into hats?
Absolutely, more and more men. And I would have brought a selection of men's hats today, but we're happy to say that the men, other than my hat, which I made, the men have come in and bought all our hats out. So
incredible.
We're madly trying to produce those some more.
This shape is amazing. I had to ask David what it was made out of. I couldn't tell. It's straw.
It is straw.
So it's light.
It is straw with a silk brim.
Gorgeous.
Thank you.
Gorgeous.
Thank you.
You like to have lots of fun and whimsy, and your hats don't all look the same, which is what I love. Tell me about this black and white
one. Well, so each season I create a Queen's Plate couture collection, so the next three pieces are from that, and that's where I get to go wild. That's where I'm indulged as a hat maker and can just create pure fantasy. So I decided to go with a little whimsy this year. So this particular one is a silk base. It's covered in silk. And feathers are my favorite thing to work with, so I just had to make something with a little bit of feathers.
I just realized these are feathers.
They're all feathers. It's all handmade, everything.
Flowers.
Right down to how this was put together, it's all hand-sewn.
So incredible.
It's an original 1940s block, and I decided that I just thought this shape was so elegant, and to me it felt modern, so perfect for the Queen's Plate.
They really all have personalities, in particular this daisy one. Now, it's got a very different shape to it, both in the hat, I guess I'm going to call it the hat portion, and then this waterfall effect.
Oh, thank you so much. Well, I call this one Daisy Love, and daisies are my favorite flower in the entire world, so I had to make them this year. I was very honored this season to have hats on exhibition in London Hat Week, and while there I was able to do some master flower making study work. So I learned to make these daisies by hand using French flower pressing tools, so I just thought they'd be perfect for the Queen's Plate collection. This year the Queen's Plate is celebrating its 160th year, and I don't know if you know, but the wreath that goes around the winning horse, it is covered in flowers, and those flowers are chrysanthemums and daisies.
Right.
So how could I not make something honoring that tradition?
The perfect chapeau, and also hello you in London at the hat makers. Come on.
Right?
Canada proud.
Thank you.
I want to get to the beautiful white plume first, but let's talk about the pink one before we do.
Well, the pink one is actually named after my mentor, Miss Rose Corey. So we call this the Lady Rose Corey. And I just thought a simple, clean, but elegant pink and white hat with a simple, well, in my world, simple feather embellishment would be perfect for the Queen's Plate.
The shape.
Keep the sun off your face, look elegant, finish your outfit.
Nice and light, because it will be a hot day.
Absolutely.
Okay, this piece, David.
Ah,
this is right out of My Fair Lady. It is gorgeous.
Well, it's a little My Fair Lady gone mad, but again, as the official milliner to the Queen's Plate, how could you not indulge yourself with a little madness? So we have some flowers. We have, I believe there is just shy of 100 ostrich feathers that are individually wired and placed on that particular piece. So
100 ostrich feathers.
Yes, ma'am.
Who would wear this?
Well, I'd like to say who
JP
wouldn't wear
says
it?
Me.
So, you know, I have worn it as celebrities have worn it to the Queen's Plate.
It is fabulous. I'm going to try it on a little bit later. David, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you for having
us. Thank you for bringing these beautiful hats and fascinators. A reminder, you can catch the Queen's Plate. I mean, the horses are there, but the hats will be too.
Yes, we'll be in the hats and horseshoe section.
You'll be the hats and horseshoe section? Amazing. That will be on the Queen's Plate Saturday on CTV and TSN. Thanks for watching. If you like this, be sure to subscribe here.
And you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.